Hi, and welcome to this demo on how to combine the powerful capabilities of IBM Db2 Warehouse with the flexibility of a Jupyter notebook. In this video, we will use PySpark to analyze streaming data coming from an IoT device and see how to make the streaming data land in IBM Db2 Warehouse. This notebook is connected to IBM Db2 Warehouse using Livy, which is an open-source REST service for Apache Spark. You can use Livy with Spark Magic in a Jupyter notebook to execute Spark jobs easily. Refer to the README file for information about how to configure a Livy connection. A Livy connection enables you to work on a Jupyter notebook, which you open locally, but that runs on a Spark cluster with IBM Db2 Warehouse. Let's go back to our notebook. Our use case is to stream data from a wind turbine that is sent by an IoT device. Let's get started. First, we set up the data producer. For this demo, we simulate an IoT device by using a container to generate sample data as if from a wind turbine. All the files and instructions are available on our GitHub repository. After having built the Docker image, which is called IoT Producer, run the Docker container with this command. You can also print out the generated data. Here, you can see the flow of generated data second after second. For more information about how to set up this IoT producer container, refer to the documentation on our GitHub repository. Now, let's go back to our notebook. We have our streaming data, which we are pretending is coming from wind turbine sensors, but which in fact is coming from our little container with the name IoT Producer. The IoT Producer container sets up an Apache Kafka server on a port and sends a constant flow of sensor data. We're here in the Jupyter notebook and we'll send the data to a Db2 table. First things first, here are the imports. As we run the first cell to import the necessary PySpark classes, a Livy session is started in the background, and you can see that a Spark session is also starting. It is available as Spark. In this second cell, we retrieve the Spark session created by Livy. Next, we check if Kafka assembly is available. If not, we import it. Same for Kafka SQL. In our case, Kafka assembly and Kafka SQL have been found, so we can go on. If otherwise, we have to get the libraries and restart the notebook. We are now ready to send streaming queries to access data from our IoT producer container. First, we subscribe to a topic called IoT for -db. It is a property of the IoT producer that we have set before. The sRow is a data frame to collect data flowing from the IoT device to the notebook. This is a typical row Kafka format with the value field containing the actual data in a nested format. We will extract the data in the next step. We define another data frame with a query and contains the values from the sRow as strings. We are now ready for data collection and exploration. So far, we have created some objects and done some setup, but we have not collected any data. Let's do it. Make sure the IoT producer is active before running the next cell. We define SQL data frame streams on the basis of our two PySpark.SQL data frames DS row, and DS. We call them row query and turbine query, respectively. When you execute the cells, queries begin to run. They won't stop collecting data until you say so. That's why, after a few seconds, we stop them with the stop method. We can now take a look at the data that we have just collected. We have indeed the columns specified in the schema we had previously printed. Values are not easily readable yet. We will preprocess them later. The topic is indeed IoT for -DB, and inherently to streaming data, you have a timestamp column. Here, we display a few rows from the table containing values as strings. You see that they are in a nested, JSON-like format. Let's define a proper schema before we can cleanly save our data into a DB2 table. In this cell, we use a while loop to collect a predetermined amount of records from the data stream. Data is collected in batches. The size of a batch can vary because although the total amount of rows to be collected is set, the number of rows per batch is determined by the timeout variable. You can see the data corresponding to each batch there. Now, it is time to see how to write this data into a DB2 table. This cell collects some more columns of fresh data, parses the raw data to extract the values from the nested format, and this batch by batch. We print the first 10 records for you. To conclude this notebook, let's visualize our time series. In this demo, we do it on the client side, not on the server side. Look at the local magic at the beginning of this cell. It ensures that plots are outputted locally. Additionally, the matplotlib inline magic ensures that figures are not plotted in a separate window, but are directly embedded in this notebook. To plot our data locally, we make a bridge between remote and local with an SQL query to create a view of our data stored in DB2. We obtain a pandas data frame that we will use for visualization. Here, we just have the points corresponding to a specific sensor. And in this last cell, we have plotted both the temperature and the power production of a turbine over time. Visit our GitHub repository to download this notebook and play around with it. You will also find other useful demos and tutorials for IBM DB2 Warehouse. Deploy your application easily and run it anytime on IBM DB2 Warehouse. Thanks for watching.